Good morning friends, today we are going to see block diagram and working principle of switch mode power supply. So before that we have completed fixed regulators. Today we are going to see switch mode power supply. There is a lot of difference between linear regulator and switch mode regulator. Switch mode power supply, which is operated at the high frequency, so that we are having some of the advantages. High switching frequency, which allows smaller value of LNC, thereby it reduces size, cost and weight, and also it reduces the ripples at the output, so we get constant DC regulated output. Next one, the range of operating frequency for SMPS is 10 to 50 kilohertz, which produce the maximum efficiency. Let us see the detailed block diagram of SMPS. The oscillator circuit, which produce the triangular wave at a constant frequency, which is given to the non-inverting terminal of comparator. So thereby the comparator compares the error voltage along with triangular wave. Here the switching transistor, either it can on, that means saturation state, or off, it is a cutoff state. So from the unregulated voltage is given to the collector of the switching transistor Q. From that, the output is taken from collector, which is passed to the filter. The filter which provides the smooth output in the regulated one. So the V naught may be either increase or decrease. Based on that, the output has to be controlled. Suppose, for example, if the voltage increases, V naught increases, it is fed back to the error amplifier. The error amplifier which compares already fixed reference voltage, which produce the error DC output voltage. Again, this is given to the comparator. This is the generalized working principle. Let us come to two cases. For example, the V naught increases, the ultimate aim is to control the regulated output. For example, the V naught decreases means the V naught is the, that is VF is fed back to the error amplifier. So V naught decreases, VF also decreases, which is connected to the positive terminal of error amplifier. From that, the error voltage, DC voltage also gets decreased. This decreased voltage is given to the comparator. The comparator, it can compare triangular wave and the error DC voltage. For example, the error DC voltage is reduced. During this time interval, compared to triangular wave, the error DC voltage is reduced. The T on period will be increased. So T on increases, the transistor will be on for the T on time, so that it produced required increased output. For example, case 2, V naught may decreased. So V naught may, first case the V naught may decrease. Now the second case, V naught is increased. So V naught is increased, the feedback voltage VF, which is voltage across the R2, which can be calculated V naught into R2 divided by total resistance R1 plus R2, which is given to the error amplifier. So V naught increases, VF increases, thereby increasing the error voltage. So this error voltage, again compare with the comparator. So the error voltage is increases, the error voltage is increases, T on decreases, so T on period will be decreases. So the total duty cycle of the transistor T on and T off controls the output voltage, thereby regulating the DC output voltage. These are the following advantages for the SMPS. Thank you for watching this video.